I'm back with more cybersecurity fundamentals. And this time we're talking about consulting, cybersecurity consulting, because it's the most exciting job in the world. No, it's actually pretty exciting. Let's talk about it. All right, so consulting in cybersecurity. Consulting is a great cybersecurity job for people who like to travel. And for those of you who don't like to travel, there are consulting jobs where you can do remote work. But consulting is what it sounds like. It's where you talk to people and tell them things that they probably wish they knew. And then they get billed by the hour. But, you know, what is it like to be a consultant? It depends on what company you work for and you do consulting for. And it depends on, you know, is it a company that's a managed service provider, for example, or a company that builds their own product? I've worked for different types of companies and talk a little bit about both. And from my experience, everything I'm saying is from my experience. I can't say for everyone on the planet's experience for what cybersecurity consulting is like, but for the most part, you have consulting for, say, like a managed service provider, where that's a person who is contracted to help companies out, and they work with, say, like just a bunch of companies. So like an IT company that people outsource IT to that so happens to do cybersecurity, or like a company that only does cybersecurity for setting up companies' security awareness programs, so on and so forth, where they provide different types of products and different types of services around IT, cybersecurity, whatever it may be, and they bill people by the hour. Now, if it's for, say, like a company who is a dedicated product developer, say like they develop their own cybersecurity tools, then the job of a cybersecurity consultant is oftentimes where you go out, install the software for people, and then teach them how to use the product that's developed in-house. It's a lot more straightforward, a lot less nebulous, and it's much easier to explain. But at the end of the day, the thing that is the same across all consulting jobs is that sometimes they're called professional services positions. So if you see a job that says professional services, it's potentially a consulting job, and it could be, once again, for a managed service provider or for a company that develops their own tools. I'm sure there are exceptions to that. Of course, there are exceptions to everything. So, regardless, when you are actually working as a consultant, the primary goal is to more or less keep your customers wanting to buy more service from you. And if you're providing genuinely good service that's worth their time, then people will buy more service from you. If you're wasting their time and you're not doing anything that's viable to a company, then they're not going to keep working with you. And so if it's a company who is trying to get a new cybersecurity tool installed and you work for the company that builds that tool and you're going out there to deploy the new tool, then you might get contracted on. This company is paying like $400 to $500, maybe even $1,000 an hour. They're paying your company. Your company is expecting you to work, say, however many hours that the company paid for. So a company will be like, we want to pay for 8 consulting hours. So you maybe go out for one day and spend 8 hours teaching them how to do whatever it is that they need to do, or deploying the software and completing a task that they paid for to get done. Now, if a company doesn't have enough hours that they paid for a project, then either they need to buy more hours. And then as a consultant, then you would recommend how many hours they need to buy. And a really good consultant also does not have goals to overbill people. And so they try to get people the most benefit and the best results for whatever they're paying. That's a good consultant. There are consultants who are just try to bill. They're like, I don't know what to do, so I'm just going to try to bill as many hours as possible. But customers usually tire of them and don't want to keep paying for those consultants for good reasons. And so if you wanted to be a consultant, one of the other benefits to that is sometimes you'll be going to other countries or other states. And if you're doing, say, like a big trip to another state or country, it might not just be 8 hours, it might be a whole month. You might be contracted to be out there for a whole month for a huge project on something like, say, a dark site. A dark site is an area where there's shielded infrastructure that is potentially not even online, and there's no online access there, and you're gonna be in this high security silo. Or maybe it's a company that doesn't have a dark site and they just want to make sure that they have a person who's going to help them set up a security awareness program for the very first time, and they're just trying to get started. They have no idea what they're doing, and you're there to help ensure their success without them having to necessarily hire a contractor who's not a consultant, because you can be a contracting consultant. But anyways, usually a consultant is a specialist, and oftentimes a consultant works for another company. And if you're traveling as a consultant for another company, they pay for your food, they pay for your travel, they pay for your plane tickets, they pay for everything. If you're running your own consulting company, make your customers pay for your travel and food and whatnot. Don't pay for that yourself unless you're like just rolling in the dough. But that's if you're your own contractor. It's just a recommendation that I have. Or charge enough to where you can pay for all your own stuff and not charge that directly to your clients. But at the end of the day, consulting is a lot of just trying to keep your customers happy and trying to sell them as many hours as you can, coming up with things that are hopefully valuable that would keep them wanting to buy service from you. It's almost like being an employee that doesn't want to get fired at 20 companies a year. That's what it can feel like sometimes. And I will say that even though the travel is great and it's a great opportunity, sometimes it can burn you out. It's a very intense job and the travel can get to people. And so some jobs are remote where you just spend more of your time on your phone or doing, say, screen share sessions where you're showing them how to do things on your screen, or doing a remote connection where you're working on their machines and helping control things. So that's what it's like to be a cybersecurity consultant. It's a great job, really, and it's one that pays very well. It's one of the highest paying jobs. Cybersecurity consulting, as long as you're good at people, you can easily find a job that pays $80,000 a year, and then with billing bonuses, make $140,000 a year if it's a company that pays out commissions for, you know, selling hours. Alternatively, if it's not a company that does that, then sometimes they'll just give you a salary and they won't pay you extra for whatever you bill. And you might be able to just get a salary that's $100,000 a year, $120,000 a year. Pretty standard. There are people who after about 3, 4, 5, 6 years might make $150,000 a year as a cybersecurity consultant. So it really depends on what company you're working for. Some companies have a lot more money than others and they can pay, you know, up to $200,000 a year. Some companies don't have a lot of money and they can only afford to pay $60,000 a year, which I say only, and some people sit there and are like, I wish I could make $60,000 a year. But it is a job where your existence in the company is constantly billing, which means that the company has more money to pay you that they can't necessarily pay someone else who's not in a role that makes the company money. Because if you're billing $450 an hour, then the amount that you're billing your clients, go figure your company has more money to pay you, which is one of the reasons why consulting is one of the easiest ways to make a lot of money in cybersecurity, especially if you don't have a whole lot of experience. And it's a great starting point for people who just want to skip low salary ranges, still learn, and are good with people. If you hate working with people, you will hate being a consultant. It's not fun for people who hate working with people, and it's, don't do it. But if you like working with people, it can be great. Like, some people end up just getting into consulting and are like, I'm here for the travel, or I'm here for the people, or I'm here for the people and the travel. And for the right person, it's a great job. So consider it if you like people, and potentially if you like to travel.